Now I welcome you, sir, to deliver the lecture on this topic of right to information, problems and passion.
I feel very proud to be here today, this evening, to share some of my views with you as far as progressive piece of enactment, right to information, is concerned. This is my first visit to this university campus. I heard much about this university, but it is my first visit. But luckily, the thought of organizing one program on RTI in this university. So our country is such a great heritage, culture and history background that our universities like Nalanda, Takshashila was very popular in those days when the whole world was struggling for civilization. We were in a position to impart education to the various country students. From that era to present era, the universities are coming so close and synchronized with other developments in somewhere, and at the same time in some of the universities going down with the level of education. Today you see in our country the pathetic situation that our employability of the degree holders is less than 20%. When we compare with the developed countries like Europe and America, it is more than 80%. So that is also the second side of the coin, which is the pathetic situation. But university coming forward to spread the message of right to information among its students as well as the teaching faculty, and through them sending this message to down the level to percolate this message, it is definitely we must appreciate that thought perception. I would like to congratulate on this aspect as far as this decision is concerned. And for the main theme of the day, this the problems and prospects. Both are the contradictory words. Problems one side and the prospects other side. We must work out prosperity and probabilities and prospects from the problem, because problem is at one end, and we must come out from the problem to get prosperity. That's the process of human evolution, what the lesson we can learn from it. That's every prosperity is coming over from a problem. In right to information also, for that matter, you take any progressive piece of enactment in this country. The situation in initial stages, in intermediate stages, even at the matured stage also, we will face certain problems. But the only thing, solution before us is to come out from those problems. This right to information, incidentally, is clubbed with awareness. For that matter, in the country like India, which is a progressing country, of course, it is not so developed country, but developing country. Being a developing country, we will definitely have that sort of problems, because of this problem is linked up and associated with so many peripheral problems like our resources, our literacy problem, our population problem, our political system, and plurality of the society. These are the several aspects are there which are sometimes contributing to the different new issues as problems. So that's why to overcome this problem, we must take the contemporary issues also along with this. We cannot see this right to information act, its progressiveness, its components and its impact and usage by the people, by isolating it with the ground situations. We must take ground realities into the consideration. With these aspects, if we discuss this, this is very potential piece of enactment in Indian independence. You go back to the history of 65 years of Indian independence. This is a pro-citizen enactment. It is not, no provision in this act is in favor of the state, but most of the aspects are in favor of citizen. and citizen friendly, and the provisions incorporated in the law, if you deeply analyze, you will definitely notice that without even somebody coming to tell you about this, this has been adopted by the activists rather than the bureaucrats. Naturally, you take 90-95% of enactments in this country will be, the bill will be adopted by the officials, bureaucrats, with the guidance of the political executive. But incidentally, in this case, this has been adopted by the activists outside the frame of the government. So that's why the very important and very stringent provisions of the law enabling system, compelling them towards to the transparency in governance. But one thing I would like to share with you, thus they, even today, even amongst the intellectual community, there are wrong notions and wrong concepts and what you say that preconceived notions about this act without knowing the what is the actual thing. Somebody makes an observation that he was questioning in one meeting in Mari Chanaridi Institute recent back. He was asking if this is so beautiful enactment and very revolutionary piece of enactment, why this much of late in this country, which is the biggest democracy on the earth? Ours is the biggest democracy on the earth. Then that is again a wrong notion, because this right is not new. It is not conferred on citizen in 2005. Right is very old. The only thing is act is new. Right is as old as we adopted our Indian constitution in 1950. From that day onwards, this getting access to information is the fundamental right of the citizen. But there is no system to allow the people to avail this right, which has been guaranteed by the constitution. You see, today we are enjoying freedom of press in this country, but you cannot find even a single word in your constitution, entire constitution, you can't find even a word or phrase about the freedom of press. But even then, we are enjoying full strength of freedom of press here. We are second to none on this earth as far as availing freedom of press is concerned. How we are enjoying this? Because it is very much part and parcel of Article 19(1)(a). It is as the freedom of expression, we are availing this right of freedom of press under the freedom of expression. Its further expansion is the freedom of getting access to information. You take for any such freedom of expression to avail that right which has been guaranteed by the constitution, before such expression we must formulate something in our mind. There is lot of controversy whether to go for polavaram or not to go, whether to go for separate Telangana or to keep the entire state united. There is lot of controversy. In all such situations, being an Indian citizen under this constitution, I have every right to express my view whether to go for Telangana or to keep the state intact, whether to go for polavaram or polavaram is, of course, it may give benefit for some reason, but it is determined to the other reason. If that is the issue, I have freedom to express my view as far as polavaram is concerned, because 19(1)(a) is there. But before that, I must formulate something in my mind to promote argument in favor of polavaram or against polavaram. Okay. For such formulation, I must know what is polavaram, where it is going to be constructed, on which river, with what height, with that height, how many hectares going to be cultivated newly, and with that height of project, how many villages going to be inundated. Without knowing all these things, I cannot formulate certain opinion about polavaram. So getting access to information is the ingredient here to avail my right of freedom of expression under 19(1)(a). Similarly, everything, for everything in democracy, it is mandatory that well-informed citizenry is the prerequisite of democracy. That's why people must be informed about every happening in the government, what the government is contemplating for the sake of people, and what government is executing in day-to-day affairs. And that is the right of the citizens to know. So this has been categorically pronounced by the Supreme Court several occasions. In 1976, there was a popular case, Rajnaran versus Government of India case. Not in that case alone, in several judgments, Supreme Court said that getting access to information is the fundamental right of the citizen, and providing such information and keeping everything transparent in governance is the mandation for any government. That was the judgment by the Supreme Court. But incidentally and unfortunately, there was no system to provide information in the governance. If somebody approached some small office, cubicle office in MRO office of this Madhapur area or this Sheikhpet area, if one MRO denies information to the citizen, where he has to go, he has to knock the doors of the court for the justice by invoking Article 19(1)(a), where it is implied right of getting access to information, where my right is there and it has been infringed and this MRO is not following that, I am not getting information, so that's why. For that, he needs a constitutional expert, and with the help of constitutional expert, he has to go to the court, and courts are not so leisurely sitting today. You see what is the pendency before the courts in this country? You take, for example, today is the 21st October 2010. If we stop taking new cases today onwards, by filling all the vacancies from small cubicle court to the highest constitutional court of Supreme Court, by filling all the vacancies, if we stop taking the old pending cases, such all pending cases will be completed by 2033, provided subject to not take even single case today onwards. If that is the situation with the judiciary, this has been quoted by one top eminent jurist of this country. This is not my observation. So if that is the case, if some fellow who denied information at MRO office, if he wants to get information, no court will come for his rescue. In this situation, it is mandated that there must be one operator's instrument for sharing information, giving information, putting information into the public domain and freely. Then people, there must be an apparatus where with the help of that instrument they can get access to information. For that sake, 2005 enactment came into force, but it is not new right. It is only new enactment, but right is very old. So this awareness must go into the public masses. But again, it is clubbed with the so many issues, as we discussed it, that the illiteracy is a big problem here in this country, and government responsibility and accountability, answerability. Three main purposes behind bringing this piece of legislature is that one is the transparency in governance, and second, making the system accountable and answerable, and third, to contain corruption, to reduce the corruption. With these three aims, in the preamble has been mentioned in the act that these are the three aspects behind this bringing the piece of enactment in 2005. As we discussed that this is the right of the citizen to know the information, the automatic second side of the coin, it is the obligation of the government to give information to the public. Because whose information is this? People's information. The citizen, public information. Information is not of the government. The all machinery, government officers, they are not the owners of information. They are only custodians of information. But information, real owner is the citizen. Because in any democracy, the people are the ultimate sovereign in democracy. But that phrase looks very nice when it used in speeches and essay writings, but not in reality. You go and see in the field what is the situation there. There was a great definition has been given by none other than Abraham Lincoln. Democracy is for the people, of the people, by the people. But unfortunately, over a period of time, not FOR, we made it for the people. Not OF, we made it OFF, of the people, and not BY. BUY, the people at the time of election, and do what comes to your mind for the rest of 5 years. This is the prevailing situation. So how parity between the practice and the law established and constitution and its guarantees? So in that scenario, even in Indian conditions, with a long marathon struggle of 1.5 decades, this law came into force in 2002 in a different name and different form. The NDA government came out with the Freedom of Information Law in 2002. But most unfortunate thing is because of no rules has been made by this concerned governments, and it was not operationalized. And 2 years was passed without practice of the law after the enactment. That was the unfortunate situation. And subsequently in the UPA 1, they came out because of that. This is their election assurance to keep their word. They came out with this law. But most fortunate thing, while making this law, there was a big participation of civil society organizations. And while making the provisions of the law, they incorporated. I would like to share a little bit, but I am not going typically what section 2 says, what 3 says, what 12 says, what 20 says. I don't want to kill your precious and valuable time here by mentioning those provisions, because you are at university level. Simply, if you spare 1 hour for this act, it will be clear, crystal clear picture before your eyes about this act. So that's why I am not discussing much about the provisions of the law. But there are tremendous provisions like, any citizen of the country can get information. There is no locus standi. What sort of information, what way you are related, why you are asking this information. There is no locus standi. Anybody can ask any information. And while seeking information, there is no need to disclose the reason why you are asking information. You need not disclose. Because you are the citizen of this country, you have that right to get access to information. So that's why there is no need to disclose reason. As long as it is the right of the citizen, one side of the coin, automatic second side of the coin, it is the obligation of the government to give you the information. They are at that end and we are at enjoying the right end. But one more thing, the success of RTI majority times depends on the how often people are invoking this provision to question the authority. That is the important thing. Unlike other enactments, just now we discussed that there are tremendous good laws in this country, like poverty alleviation, land reforms, nationalization of banks, and so many enactments. There are number of good piece of enactments, but bad practice of good law also results in zero. That was happening all these years. So this law also, sometimes you see 1986, the awareness, as far as the awareness is concerned, definitely we must think one thing, mere awareness is not going to solve our problem. A step ahead than the awareness, we must little bit dynamic, we must start using the law. Just knowing is not sufficient. We must start using, then only we will get benefit. Otherwise, you see 1986, there is revolutionary piece of enactment, that is the Consumer Rights Protection Act. That is really tremendous piece of enactment, because who is not consumer, tell me? A small kid who started life from that stage to the last breath of a man. We are, at every stage, we are consumer for one commodity or other service. Where that will protect the rights of consumers, that revolutionary piece of enactment in the initial years, 87, 88, 90, till the 91, 92, we were the budding journalists by that time. There was number of cases against this service agencies as well as the production units. There's a number of cases there was in the forums. But today, unfortunate thing is that there was no cases in forums. Because of inadequate number of cases in the forums, government is closing down number of forums in this country. So, but it doesn't mean that there is no cheating as far as consumer is concerned. In different forms, in different shapes, people are coming with lot of new innovative things and new creative ideas to the cheat people. Not the production units alone, even the service agencies also. We are compromising everywhere. दस रुपए का बिस्किट पैकेट रेलवे स्टेशन में 15 रुपए को देता, क्यों 15 रुपए 10 रुपए आ रहे, जाओ भाई मैं कितना खरीद करके ये शॉप लिया बोलता। यू टुक बाय पेइंग मोर, ज्यादा पैसे बना के तुम यहां शॉप लिया, नॉट टू सेल मोर देन एमआरपी, बिकॉज ए स्मॉल शॉप आउटसाइड द स्टेशन इज सेलिंग 100 बिस्किट पैकेट्स इन ए मंथ, ही विल गेट 1 रुपी मार्जिन 100 रुपीज, बट यू आर सेलिंग 1000 बिस्किट पैकेट्स इन रेलवे स्टेशन विद द सेम 1 रुपी मार्जिन, यू आर गेटिंग 1000 रुपीज, दैट्स वाई यू पेड मोर फॉर गेटिंग दिस शॉप, नॉट टू सेल एट 15 रुपीज। बट वी कॉन्ट फाइट विद देम, इवन वी स्टार्ट फाइटिंग इन ए सिनेमा थिएटर, 4 रुपया का समोसा 8 रुपया को देता, मैं 10 रुपया को देता, 10 रुपये का वो कूल ड्रिंक बॉटल है 20 रुपये को देता, एक गाड़ी पार्क करने के लिए 10-15-20 रुपये बन गया आज। अगेन ही विल सेल दैट, आई वोंट टेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, यू ओनर्स आर एट रिस्क फॉर लॉस ऑफ व्हीकल, देन व्हाई यू आर कलेक्टिंग ह्यूज मनीज फ्रॉम पीपल। इफ वी स्टार्ट फाइटिंग विद दैट फेलो, अरे 4 रुपये का समोसा क्यों तुम 10 रुपये का दे रहे हो, लेना है तो लो, नहीं तो नहीं साहब, देन समटाइम्स वी रेसिस्ट एंड समटाइम्स we will go with force that I won't take with you, वापस ले लो बोल के बाहर आता, कब तक आता, ग्रिल तक आता, वहां रोका जाता, the grill will be closed and locked because it is a connivance business between the theater owner as well as this samosa vendor, so we cannot fight much against with me, even अपना साथी आया बच्चा बोलता बाप महीने में एक बार सिनेमा को लाता, ये क्या समोसा फाइटिंग आया, वो सीन अच्छा है, सीन मिस हो रहा है, हम बोलता देन यस नेचुरल इट इज वी कांट फाइट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कॉम्प्रोमाइज नेचर, बट राइट टू इंफॉर्मेशन एज फार एज यूसेज ऑफ आरटीआई इज कंसर्न, आई वुड लाइक टू गिव यू एग्जाम्पल, इट इज टोटली कंट्राडिक्टरी विथ अदर एनएक्टमेंट्स, अनलाइक अदर एक्ट्स। You see, we have in our democratic setup, there is executive, the legislature, political executive, legislature, after that executive, the judiciary, and the free press, which is the fourth estate. The most of the enact, so that's why unless you question the authority, you won't get any benefit. For that questioning all these years, we are in dark. But today, we could able to get a light with RTI. RTI is not solution, try to understand. Again, people are mistaken that RTI may give some help for us. It is not solution. It is not jinda tilasmat to apply, headache, knee pain. Everywhere you can use jinda tilasmat, but RTI is not jinda tilasmat. RTI is not solution, but while getting solutions to your problem, it is your friend. Which will help you. You can seek the support of RTI. You can penetrate into that darkness where all these years you are in dark and no information. What is the scheme? How to get? Who the benefited? Why I am not benefited? But with the help of RTI, you can get all this information. What is Indiramma? What is the criteria for selection of Indiramma? How many villages allotted to my village? And who applied for this? And who got ultimately? And why I denied? Though I applied? Before questioning, before putting such question, you must know what is Indiramma? What is the criteria? Who applied for it? Who got it? And who denied it? Put simply 5 questions, pay 10 rupees, get information, then you will be on a pedestal where you can question the authority. In that way, RTI will help you, but don't believe that RTI is going to be solve your problem on its own without your effort. I can give you a small example where a fellow, an ordinary fellow, getting benefit with the help of RTI. For example, if you seek certain provision, like you, I am the more eligible fellow, who is ineligible is getting ration card. Why I denied my ration card? Please provide me ration card. I am putting an application under RTI by paying 10 rupees. He will simply reject your application. What you are asking is execution of certain action. Actions not comes under RTI. Only you can seek information, but you cannot ask any particular provision under this law. That's why, hence I am rejecting your application. But some fellow, some activist guided a small fellow Jangaya in Jagityal of Karimnagar how to get ration card by taking the help of RTI. Simply, he took one white paper. With the help of activist, he wrote question number one. Sir, I requested you ration card in February of this year. I enclosed two. One is my caste certificate and my income certificate. Are these two certificates enough to get ration card? So question number one. Question number two. If that is true, what is the time frame to give ration card? And I applied 8 months back. Who held responsible for non-supply of ration card? Question number two. Then question number three. If that is the case, for failure to provide ration card, who held responsible and what action according to your service provisions initiated against that officer? Please inform me. 1, 2, 3 questions, he filed applications in the GAN. You see, there was no response. But subsequently, when new officer came, there was a review in Karimnagar by the commission, and commission banged them. You have to dispose all the cases within the stipulated time. Otherwise, you have to show the reason, valid reason why that was not disposed in time. With the impact of that review meeting, one new officer searched in his office how many pending applications. In Jagityal case, there is one pending application of Jangaya. The what answer they can give? The result is that somebody gone to the Jangaya's house. Jangaya, how office ko? Sab bulaya. So Jangaya aagaya office ko. Baito. Jangaya, aap chai lo. Arre, yehi office mein humko bahar nikal diya gaya, aap chai. Okay, theek hai, chai liya Jangaya. Chai bhi khatam nahi hua, Jangaya, aapka ration card ye. Ration card diya gaya. Ho, ration card. अच्छा है साहब, ये रेशन कार्ड ये ले, मैं कितना बार आया था ये ऑफिस को, आखिर मिल गया हमको रेशन कार्ड. जंगया, और एक बात है, तुम एक आरटीआई का दरखास्त भी दिला लेते ना इसका बार, हाउ इसका बारे में तो आप वापस लेते ना अब रेशन कार्ड. हाँ, रेशन कार्ड मिल गया, बस है सब, आरटीआई एप्लीकेशन का कोई जरूरत नहीं, हमको कोई सूचना भी जरूरत नहीं. दिस इज द पावर ऑफ दिस पीस ऑफ एन एक्ट. So we must know the truth while asking, compelling the authorities to give information, and with that we will definitely check the system and we can correct the system where the mistakes happening and mishandling of things and diversion of funds and everything. Why one MLA's relative is getting Indirama house and why a minister's follower is getting house, though they are not eligible according to the criteria, why I am fitting into the criteria but denied the house? Before such all questions, you must know what is the truth. The knowing that thing will enable you to question the authorities. Not democracy, not the definition given by the Abraham Lincoln alone, also defined by Mahatma. According to Bapu, democracy is not that giving power into the hands of few people, where in which nation every citizen must be in a position to question authorities when it is committing error. That is the democracy. If that democracy, to make it truth, we all must be equipped with the information. For getting that information and getting access to that information, we must use the provisions of RTI. In that way, RTI will help the society. Of course, somebody may say that, RTI bhi aake 5 saal ho gaya, kya sudhar hua? One may question like that. But institutions and the systems you cannot change overnight. Just switch on off, you can get light and dark. Like that, you cannot change the systems. For changing systems, it will take its own time. But to reduce that time gap, we must do an effort, combined effort. Governments must be transparent. Commissions must be proactive. Bureaucracy must be open. And the civil society must be dynamic. And they have to go for every intervention, because the country like India, where the people struggling with the so many issues. Really, the pathetic situation in this country is the economic disparities you see. As the political science students, you must know that, and the faculty, they are doing their best effort to give a picture, scenario about this country and the prevailing situation before you. It's a very pathetic and very, very dangerous situation prevailing in this country. 7-8 years back, there was one event when Switzerland finance minister visited our state. Incidentally, I was a reporter to cover that event. That then chief minister was also there in Dais. Two, three economists of this country, they are giving a beautiful rosy picture about the Indian economy, how it is going to be flourishing. And India is going to become second fastest growing economy in this world. And because of vast human resources of this country, we are exploring everywhere in the world, and our people are going there and extending services in every nook and corner of this world. And even our rural economy is going to be flourishing like this thing, that thing, that this, blah, 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 blah. They were telling, and they said they are going to achieve 8% annual growth rate. Then Switzerland finance minister was laughing at it. And when his turn came, he was talking that with your poor infrastructure in this country, which is supposed to be there in 1960s. Now you are struggling for that roads and sanitation and electricity and drinking water. With your poor literacy rate, Akshara Jyoti, Akshara Sankranti, Akshara Ganga, I don't know those names of the different educational schemes. And Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, you know that the scandalous affair of that 1100 crores per year, like that 5 consecutive years in this state. You say the 1100 mandals we are having, 1100 crores every year, and each mandal will get 1 crore, like that 5 consecutive years. One mandal will consist of 25 gram panchayatis and 5 crores rupees for the school buildings. There should not be even single school without shelter, but today 40% of schools beneath the trees. Where this money gone? With all these efforts, literacy, not literacy reading and writing. If Ramaya, who can write Ramaya, is also literate, we are considering. Even with that calculation, 60 years of our independence, we never crossed the mark of 60% literacy rate in this country. And population, we never try to control. 17% of world population we constitute today, relying on 2% of resources. Very unfortunate equation. With this situation and these conditions, you are going to achieve 8% growth rate. If I say these words in my country, either they will put me behind the bars because I am giving wrong fictitious figures to mislead the people. Otherwise, they will put me in mental hospital because my mental status is not correct. So this was the utterance by the Switzerland finance minister in this state. But that is not the cruel joke. The cruelest joke is that we achieved 8% growth rate. Yeah. In the next year, we achieved 8% growth rate. But numericals always give the false and fictitious picture sometimes of truth. 8% growth rate is also correct, but it is not uniformly reflecting our society. Our calculations, for that matter, every numerical calculation will give fictitious picture that if you see, you imagine in one hostel room, two students are there, one fellow having 1,000 rupees in pocket, other fellow not a penny even to go for a cup of chai, but our calculations, both will have 500-500. That is the GDP calculations. In this country also today, wealth has been projected like that with our annual growth rate of 8%. But rich becoming richer and poor becoming poorer because of unequal opportunities. Otherwise, tell me, why one Mukesh Ambani is the pride owner of 3,75,000 crore rupees in this country, where lakhs and crores of people are struggling for one-time meal? They are not asking your bungalows, they are not asking your cars, they are not asking your wealth and assets. Simply, they are asking one-time meal in a day, otherwise they may not survive. 40%, 35-40% of population below poverty line. These economic inequalities is not at all a considerable aspect as far as growing society is concerned. So in our society, that is the pathetic situation. It is what happened to our five-year plans, what happened to your crores of rupees, and what happened to your welfare and development schemes. It is unequal distribution of wealth and unequal opportunities among the people. To set right this issue, to get equal opportunities, let the information go into the public domain, and people will come to know what is the truth, and they will start questioning the authority, and let them take their own share in the democracy. So that's why RTI is a crucial element today, which will give support to those people who are voiceless people, and it will become voice of the voiceless. That's why that is the potentiality as we discussing the prosperity and prospects of RTI. The drawback is that our systemic lapses for years together accumulated. Today you can't find the information in one particular office. Without having information, how that fellow can give you information? That's the biggest problem here. You see, in our system, with our political executive, with a single stroke of signature, one chief minister was abolished Munasab and Karanam system in our state in 1985 till 2002 when village secretary system came. 17 years there was no system to see the taking care of revenue records in villages. What is this? What answerability and what accountability towards the people? So in that pathetic situation today, record maintenance, record management, record auditing system is worst in this state, in this country, in fact, for that matter. In recently, Second Administrative Reforms Commission recommended the government of India for better implementation of RTI in this country. We need record management must be proper in every office. Every department, in every budget, it must allocate either 0.5% or 1% or 1.5% of its regular budget for the proper maintenance of record and management of record. So computerization is the solution. Also, Right to Information Act Section 4 and Subsection 1 mandates that every public office must keep its record, catalog, indexing, computerization, and giving access with the NIC and the internet. Then people simply search and get their information, and they will come to know, and they will question the authority. Otherwise, you will be pushed to that area, and everything will be kept beneath the carpet on the name of secrecy. Why this secrecy? But unfortunate thing, we are, see, even today, our system of administration controlled with the age-old laws like 1886, 1889, 1902, 1923 Official Secrets Act. We achieved independence in 1947. British colonial system of rule. That may be the order of day when Ronnie Elizabeth was sitting there in London. They wants to rule mighty kingdom over this earth. And they wants to keep everything secret, because why jute is going to England, and why jute products coming into the India? Why cotton going to the UK, and why cotton products coming into the India by molding India as a market, cheap market for them? So if transparent governance is there, and if the information flow into the public domain, people may ask that why you are sending cotton there. You keep the cotton here only, we will prepare cloths for our own sake. So we should not allow information into the public domain. There will be no questions. After 1947, why we should be with that impression of not giving information and not maintaining transparency? So transparency is the need of the hour. Transparency will definitely compel the system to deliver goods and accountability and answerability of officer. Why he accepted this application? Why he was not disposed in time? What is the stipulations? What is the citizen charter? What is the mandated days for the registration? What is the mandated days for the issuing license? What is the fixed date of tenure for the issuing of passport? Then if he failed, why he failed? So one can start questioning the authority. So this transparency will definitely lead to such situation. Otherwise, nobody is answerable and accountable. And officials also, they need not think that Why should I give information? To whom I have to give? These are the questions naturally I face whenever I go there in Marichanared Institute or Center for Good Governance or any academy of any department. When I go for interaction with the officers, are aina kado badwel mein rehne wala saab, unka kya taluk hai yahan? Malkaji mere information poochta hai, yahan voter bhi nahi hun. Voter hone dev na hone dev, as long as he is citizen of the country. You see the Britain law, UK. Freedom of information, UK, any citizen of any country can seek information. But Indian conditions, only citizen of the India, that is enough. So, Badwel ka Rahandev ya Gadwal ka Rahandev. As long as it is information with you, you are under obligation to give that information to the citizen. That's all, the law. The time frame also, one of the beautiful components of this act is time frame. One has to give information earliest possible, in any case not later than 30 days. But meticulous interpretation is like that. Abhi RTI ka darkhas karne wala hai aaj kal. Amko thoda urgency hai sab, amko scholarship aane ka hai, jara jaldi do, mai ek mahine se pooch rahe, koi bhi nahi de rahe, RTI ka application kare, RTI ka application kare. हमको भी मालूम है आटे जाओ जाओ आज 21 तारीख है ना 21 अक्टूबर 21 नवंबर के आके मिलो. दैट इज नॉट द स्पिरिट ऑफ द एक्ट. 30 डेज इज नॉट मैंडेटरी गैप बिटवीन सीकिंग इंफॉर्मेशन एंड प्रोवाइडिंग इंफॉर्मेशन. इट इज ओनली ऑप्टिमम. यू हैव टू गिव इंफॉर्मेशन अर्लीएस्ट पॉसिबल, इन एनी केस नॉट लेटर देन 30 डेज. इफ इट इज अवेलेबल, रेडीली अवेलेबल मेटीरियल, यू गिव टूडे. Concerned clerk is not there, you give tomorrow. You are collecting and collating information within 2-3 sections of the office, you give after 10 days. But not in every case on 29th day or 30th day. In certain cases, you have to give information within 48 hours. If information relates with one person's liberty and life, you are supposed to give that information within 48 hours. Sometimes some department people says, what sort of life related and liberty related information we possess in our office? Only some police department or some other department may have. You cannot imagine like that. I will give you one classical example where that can be invoked in that fashion. One time that was Medha Patkar was on fasting. As far as Narmada project and rehabilitation package is concerned, she was demanding something from the government of India. She was on fasting. Aruna Rai filed an application with PMO, Prime Minister Office, by asking certain information. What group of ministers recommended that rehabilitation package for Narmada? Please provide me that information within 48 hours because Medha Patkar is on fasting. With this information, we want to convince her to withdraw her fasting. So her life is in risk and relates with this matter. So that's why you provide me information within 48 PMO. Within 24 hours, they provided that recommendations of group of ministers. So that's why you cannot anticipate in what fashion it will come. But you must be in a positive mind that to share information with the citizen. Because citizen is the ultimate owner of the information. One fellow from secretariat is asking me that if they are the owners of information, sir, why they are coming and filing applications with and why they are asking us? I think he was in the impression that I am putting an intelligent question. Even in the banks also, who deposited huge monies, they will stand in queue. And if any bank manager feels that hum token deta jab tak inka paisa bhi milta nahi, dekho hamara ताकत कितना है, हम कागज दिए तो उनका पैसा मिलता. नो बैंक मैनेजर एंड नो बैंक ओनर कैन फील दैट. इफ ही फील्स दैट दीज ऑल मनीस आर माइन इन माय बैंक, ही विल बी द बिगेस्ट फूल. बिकॉज मनीस आर नॉट ऑफ द बैंक मैनेजर्स आर बैंक ओनर्स, मनीस आर ऑफ द डिपॉजिटर्स. लाइक दैट दिस ओल्ड सिस्टम ऑफ गवर्नेंस इज द इंफॉर्मेशन बैंक. यू फील दैट दिस इंफॉर्मेशन बिलोंग्स टू द सिटीजन. सिटीजन डिपॉजिटेड इज इंफॉर्मेशन हियर. We, at helm of affairs, by virtue of our position as the employees, we are not the owners, we are only custodians here. That too, we are not extending any voluntary service. We are the paid custodians. That's why we must be with a positive mind that sharing information with the citizen. So bureaucracy should not think in that fashion, that mindset should go. Mindset is the big obstacle as far as this issue is concerned, as we discussed the problems of RTI. The biggest problem is that mindset. We cannot find fault with one or two individuals. Our system is like that. Boss, bossism, hierarchical system is like that. Oh, boss, jada gusse ko aata agar information diya to. As long as you are PIO designated there, you ignore and forget you are boss and you are to give information. Otherwise, you will be penalized tomorrow. You have to pay the penalty amount from your pocket. Your boss is not coming for rescue. So that's why everybody should feel that. And officers must keep in mind one thing, that we may be big officer in one department for one purpose or one particular cause, but in day-to-day affair, 100, 150 affairs, we are the ordinary citizens like any other. I may be big officer. For example, I am a big officer in police department. DGP is the top officer. One fine morning, my daughter came from college and simply she is telling that, Daddy, tomorrow onwards I am not going college. Hey, what happened, why you are not going college? Huh? We paid that much of huge donation to the college, 1 lakh or 1.5 lakh, few days back. Then if you renounce us like this, how? Then she started telling that, what bloody college, they start classes from morning 8 o'clock until 5 o'clock in the evening, not separate toilet for the girls. Yes, it is definitely a genuine problem. Then immediately this DGP telephone the principal or the correspondent, what is the civic amenities you are providing in college? What is the facilities available there? And what is the staff pattern? What is the student-teacher ratio? This, that. And that principal adamantly said that, Jao, kya aapko dene ka kya hai? Kya bolne ka kya zarurat hai? Then immediately DGP. Huh? Few days back, there was an academy, police academy, we organized one seminar, Mr. Dilip Reddy from information, he said that everything should come and whenever citizen asks, everybody has to give information, the transparency. Why this principal is talking like this? My dear DGP, not the principal alone, the transparency has to be maintained in DGP office, IG office, DIG office, SP office, DSP office, inspector office, and at cutting edge level in the minimum police station. So one must feel that when I am in need of information, how I expect the transparency in government, when I am at the position at the table, I must be with the same fashion to divulge and give information to the citizen. That's all. There is no other logic. This is the only logic. So that's why it is a question before them. And governments also, it must come forward with the, according to section 26, it is the duty of government to percolate this message down to the level the citizen. But there is no single action from the government as far as campaign and propagation about this act. Why? Answer is simple. In all 100 cases of violation of RTI, where information was denied, not in 99, in all 100 cases, government is the accused. The government don't want to stand as accused again and again. That's why they don't percolate the message into the public. That is the issue behind it. It is not the duty of commission. Its assignment has not assigned to the commission. Commission is a quasi-judicial authority with total autonomy. It has to act as the court while accepting its appeals, complaints, and it has to dispose. That's why some of the commissions in the country, commissioners never gone outside the capital of the state. But we in Andhra Pradesh, positively by taking this, not this demand side alone, even from supply side, there must be a proper understanding about the law. We went around the state. In 2005, November itself, we took this mission. And by the July of 2006, we completed all one round of 23 districts, and we went around the state, and so many, my case alone, and I made 420 district interventions for last 5 years, and I addressed more than 1,000 meetings on RTI, whether it is organized by the activists or the academies or the universities or the civil society organizations or even the employee unions and some of the political parties also. Because the message should go to the public, let the people use this and they will get answer. There need not be any cynicism about this act. Abhi tak 5 saal ho gaya, kya hua, kaha mile, kisko mile. Sometimes we must see in the comparative. In comparative scenario, you take so many agencies are there in this country. So many institutions are there, powerful institutions. For example, election commission is there. That is constitutional commission, unlike information commission. Information commission, of course, is the statutory. But whereas election commission is constitutional commission, it is so powerful. Once the elections are announced, entire administration comes under the control of election commission. Baita bolte baitna, uto bolte utna, chief secretary, who is the highest officer in this state. Agar ye collector achcha nahi bolo to nikalo. Nikal ke dusra collector, tu kon hai collector ko appoint karne ka? Teen nama bhejo, mai tick kar tum usko collector bano. But that is the power of election commission. But nobody knows about election commission till session come. That is 6-7 years back. So all the 50 years, we are in ignorance about the election commission. But as far as RTI is concerned, for last 5 years, tremendous insights. It has gone, percolated. It is again the issue of invocation by the people, usage by the people. As I mentioned, that Consumer Protection Act. If you are not using it, definitely it will get rust. So that's why use is important. For that, this is tremendous instrument in the hands of citizen as far as empowerment of citizen is concerned. So it will definitely strengthen the roots of the democracy in this country. And in this scenario where we are marching ahead to prosperity and development and competing with so many countries in the world, this is the right time to contain corruption and getting due share and equality before law, getting equal opportunities to get benefits and to make our society with better living standards and giving bright future for the future generations. This is my viewpoint as far as RTI is concerned. It should become unilateral, otherwise if you won't allow the question hour, definitely we must go for the open house question hour. And I would like to thank you, and I would like to thank the organizers for providing me a good opportunity to share here. Thank you one and all.